Hello, and welcome to a new series of Oxygen Not Included. This is a game I've played about 100 hours of so far because I just thought I'd give it a go, and then I'd give it another go, and then another go, and another go, I'm absolutely obsessed with it, so I thought I'd bring you along on the journey. It's a game by Cly, the makers of Don't Starve, and it's a game that's in early access. It's a pre-release early access. You can get your hands on it. They don't make it easy because they're at that stage of the bug testing where they're releasing hot fixes, and often they release game breaking updates to it as well. So it does come with a very heavy caveat that it's in an early pre-release state. But it's so playable. I mean, Clyde, they make good games. They're good at this. And it's so good, it's worth giving it a go. It has got a lot of bugs in it. That's something to be accepted and acknowledged, and I know an awful lot of the workarounds to it. So what I'm going to do is, because it will likely be quite soon that there'll be another update out which will either put more content in or will break the game that we're playing, I'm going to do an awful lot of recording all in one go, and then we'll release really long episodes really quickly so that it's all done, it's all out there, and we can get the game done. My main goal is, as I've played it quite a bit, I want to know how many of our little friends, our little minions, the duplicants, we can actually support on one map. So what's the maximum number I can get up to? Because if we overdo it, they'll start dying. And anyway, let's step into a game. Okay, so we start the game with three duplicants, and you can choose these three, but it takes a little while to get the perfect team. So I've already got that prepared, and we're starting with, let's see, Hideki here, who we are going to name in honor of my first ever YouTube subscriber, who was Ratzfaz. So Ratzfaz, you are going to be my first duplicant. And Ratzfaz I have selected because he is an absolute wonderful digger. And I've picked three people here with three particular skills that will help us get set up. And then we also have May here, who shall be Babom. Babom, because you're always early to the streams. And Babom is a runner, very quick. Always there first. Babom, because you're really quick, you're actually going to go in the hamster wheel generating energy for us. And then our other star person is a researcher. It's our scientist. And so this is going to be Calum. Calum, who is too smart for his own good. So Calum is, yeah, an excellent researcher. Learns things very, very quickly. And we'll be able to research stuff quickly. So, let's get going. First of all, before we can do anything else, we need to start digging some stuff out so we can start building some things. Right, guys, get going. Now, our duplicants have needs. And at this moment, the first of their needs that we need to satisfy is their need to go to the toilet. So we want to very quickly get to a point where we can build them an outhouse. But first of all, Babom has run out of things to do. So we need to give them something. Because only two of them can dig at once at the moment. So Babom, if you wouldn't mind building some floor for us, that would be quite useful. So we're going to build the floor over there, and if you can build any ceiling, you might be able to build ceiling there. Not that one though, because we're going to need to be able to walk through there. Okay, right. Now we've got some building jobs. Ratzfaz, I don't want you to do any building or delivering, because you're our best digger. And we just want you to focus on that. And just keep the digging going. Once you've got through that lot, if you can dig that, and as soon as we're through there, actually, we want to build a bit more that way. we want to get the outhouse as far away from the main base as possible. Now, while they're digging that out, we could do with doing a little bit of design work. Yeah, they can carry on digging. We're going to need a ladder to go, because we're going to want to go up and down in this space, digging vertically and horizontally. And so we want to keep it away from that water and away from that water, probably around about here. So if we had a ladder there, then actually we would want a gap there. Okay. And then we probably want to build the outhouse somewhere in here. Let's see, we would probably be having this floor about this high. Little ledge for them to jump on, and then we'll have the door. We'll put an airlock there and we'll have the toilet the other side of the airlock. Be a little while before we can actually build an airlock, but that would be a good place for us to start, I think. Calum, are you idle? Are you doing something? What are you doing? You don't look like you're doing anything. Let's see if we can get you doing something useful. How about digging a little bit down here? We can remove that without a problem. Oh, Ratzfaz, yeah, sure. So these blocks here are oxalite. They are slowly dissolving and turning into oxygen. So we don't want to dig those away. We want to leave them there for the moment. Now we could get rid of that one and that one without a problem. They'll be able to jump up there. Right, now Ratzfaz has just found, somewhere in that dirt, they found a muck root, which is a bit of food, which is handy. Come on, people. As soon as they've dug this top bit, we'll be able to get on with building that part. Now, can I get somebody doing something more useful? How about laying some tiles along here? Where do we want this to go to? We're going to want a ladder to come down. Maybe this side. Yeah, that's probably about right. So if we're having a ladder there, then we wouldn't want the tiles to go any further than there. Okay, feel free to get on with that. There you go, Calum, that'll keep you busy. And this mealwood, we're digging it up. It would be preferable if we could let it grow and just harvest it, but as it stands, we'll wait until it's actually... we'll take it down right now because we can't wait until it's ready to harvest, and we'll plant it again at some point. We'll get the seed back from it. Okay, right. Ratzfaz is stuck for something to do there. So he can't dig until he can get across. I don't want to send him doing anything else. There we go. Meanwhile, Babom and Calum will come and start building the floors and ceiling here. How are we doing for time? We need to get a toilet in for them before the end of cycle one. Because it'll be when they wake up in the morning tomorrow that they'll really want to go to the toilet very suddenly. So we're going to want it here. Well, I mean, if we can, a little bit further back would be marvellous. Looks like we might have enough time. Okay, Ratzfaz now it's just digging work to be done over there. Ratzfaz, if you could start digging this down, that would be a good idea. And also, can you get rid of that plant so it can bring the ladder down? Plumbing. Yeah, we've got time. Let's... Now, have we mined any dirt yet? Yes, we have. Good. Dirt is going to be essential to for our toilet to work. If these guys don't have a toilet by the time they need to go tomorrow, then they will make a bit of a mess on the floor. And they get rather upset about that. How are we doing? Nearly there. Okay, we're going to need that ladder building though, so that they can still get up and down. Babom, can you do that? I'm not sure Babom can. He might not have access to the materials he needs, so I am going to allow Ratzfaz to build. Okay, Ratzfaz. Let's prioritise those ladders as well. Because at the moment, Babom is probably stuck up there. Ah, but we do have the outhouse built. Calum's stuck up there as well, unfortunately. There we go. Excellent. So now that the outhouse is built and it's out the way of the base, out of the way of our main base, it'll help to keep all of the smells and things in out of the way. Now, why couldn't they... Oh, okay, Calum's gone off to get some sandstone to build that. Let's get the rest of the guys focused on something. What we can do now is to dig out that little bit. And we've got a little bit of granite, so we can start making the tiles out of granite. So we can safely build as far as that without anybody getting stuck. Oh, and it's night time. Oh, but Calum's on with something and he's going to finish that job. Yep. Before he too falls asleep. Very good. Right, while they're sleeping, let's have a look. So we've got the toilet. That was the first thing. The next most important thing is to start getting some power up. Now I want to build the power over this side so that it keeps all of the hot stuff in one place. That'll become really important later on. So we'll dig a big sort of gap along there. That'll keep two of them busy. How far do we want to go? We're going to want a ladder taking us up and down. And probably that far, because that will leave us a ladder then the gap will be here, and then there's a 3-wide wall between the water and everything else. So we'll put the ladder here. And tiles can be built all the way along. Okay, I'm not sure we've got enough granite to finish that. Oh, maybe we have. Keeps counting up and then dropping them down to zero. But we certainly want to build this as far as that. Okay, and the oxalite is gone, so we will be able to start digging out this and making this into a proper floor. That's not really our priority just yet, though. We'll get this bit built now. Oh, toilets! Toilets! Food! Oh, Babom's in a hurry. It's a long way to run. There you go. Bit of privacy, not making a mess. Oh, that looked like Babom was very relieved there. Oh, Calum next. Okay, right, now Ratzfaz, we'll get you off building again. There's a lot of digging to be done, so you can focus on that. Where's Babom going? Look how much faster Babom runs than Ratzfaz. Oh, picking up granite, I see. Ladders. Yep. Might as well build it up there. We'll eventually want the ladder actually cutting through this roof, but it'd be nice to have a bit of a roof for the moment. I think we can speed them up a little. We'll be able to dig that gap down there as well. How are we doing for... Do we have enough granite to build along here? So I don't want to leave this open to the vacuum for too long. Oh, or is it oxygen? Yeah, it is. It's our oxygen is flowing into that vacuum. Good, so they've got that mostly sealed. Gas will still pass through this gap here on the diagonal. Have we got any more granite yet? No, I think it's time to switch to sandstone. Yeah, they're working in a very poor oxygen environment over here. But because they're creating themselves a vacuum, the oxygen's being sucked across. Okay, well done, guys. You're getting pretty quick at this. And we'll get some oxygen up and running as fast as we can so that they don't spend too much time gasping for air. Oh, bless. Ratzfaz. He's fallen into a narcoleptic sleep. I think it's Ratzfaz and Calum who's also narcoleptic. Yeah. What's wrong with Babom? Babom has a negative trait as well, but I can't remember what it is. Ah, right. Everyone's run out of work. Time to dig a bit more. Oh, and it's time to go to sleep. Right, but we've got some more granite. And the reason why I'm using granite is that it gives us a positive decoration value. Now, if we're building something that has a positive decoration value, like a tile has a +5 improvement to decoration, then we want to use something which also has the highest possible decoration value. There is a bug in the game at the moment, which means that if you're building something like ladders, which have a negative value, that you're far better using something neutral like igneous rock, which we didn't have until just now. I could have built that one actually out of, which I will. Yeah, don't. Build that out of igneous rock. So what should happen is that if you have a negative value thing, if you build it out of something with positive decor, that should mitigate it. It shouldn't be as bad if it's built out of sandstone. But instead of adding the bonus, it multiplies by the bonus. So what happens at the moment is you build a ladder. If you make it out of sandstone, it's 10% worse. If you make it out of granite, it's 20% worse. If you make something like a tile out of sandstone, then it'll be 20% better. And if you make a tile out of granite, it will be 20% better. Got a little bit more granite there, so let's throw a few more tiles in. There we go. Take us to there. Now, if we can build the ladder a bit further down here, that will give the carbon dioxide that they're exhaling somewhere to go. And we want to start building the power generators. So we want a hamster wheel. And once they've done that, we want them to build... Is Calum falling asleep there? A research station. I'm not going to put that right next to the edge. I'm going to put it here. And then that will leave room for the next level research station. We'll have a couple of batteries. I'm squashing everything up at the moment because these will all get moved around in the end. And we'll put some oxygen equipment here. They can go if you guys are ready. Now, we want some power. Oh, and right, every so now and then, I think it's about every two and a half cycles or something, we get the opportunity to print a new duplicant. So let's see what we've got. We can only choose from the ones that were offered. And there's things we don't want a mouth breather. So, because they actually take twice the amount of oxygen as another duplicant. So I'm afraid, Melody and Chuanli, you're out. So it's going to be Sadie. What do we know about you? You're a general all-rounder. Quite handy early on. You can't do art. You can't fight. If you get really upset, you'll throw up everywhere. And you have very low expectations. That's not a bad thing. So who is a good all-rounder? Well, I think we have somebody else who's always early to the stream when we stream. Is not Jackson. Jacobson. Ian Jacobson, you're in. Whoa, and he's really happy about that. Cool. Right, Ian. Let's sort out some jobs. So, what we want now is we don't want anybody researching except Calum. And Calum, we don't want you on the hamster wheel or cooking. In fact, we don't really want you doing anything except researching. We'll allow you to deliver just in case nobody has delivered what you need so that you can self-serve. Now, it'd be really handy, actually, if one of you took away that block there, because it's kind of in the way. Okay, and now, start researching farming. And that's because the thing we want first is an algae terrarium. That will help us to put some oxygen back into the atmosphere quickly. And we need to do research. Do as much novice research as you need to. In the hamster wheel, the only person we want in generating power is Babom, because Babom is excellent at it. And we want to make sure that research is prioritised particularly highly, because we're going to kind of speedrun that a little. Next is we want to dig down to the water. Somewhere down here. Cool, so Babom's got the batteries fully charged. And we'll just jump into the hamster wheel as Calum uses up the charge. The batteries do lose a little bit of power by themselves. They drain slowly. But most of the power will go into Calum's research. It wouldn't be a bad thing if we could... Oh, time for bed. And they're all sleeping on the floor. Be good if we could fix that. But first of all, let's get a storage compactor built, and we'll get that tucked out the way. And then in their own time, they can, when they're not doing anything else, they'll clean up around here. Yeah, it would be good to get them in beds because they're sleeping on the floor. They've all got sore backs, and so their movement will be reduced because of that. Right, furniture. We can fix that by giving them some cots. I think we'll make the cots out of... Well, do you know, they spend a lot of time in cots. Let's at least put two down for the moment. Right, Ratzfaz is out of work. He can't dig any lower, otherwise he'll get stuck. So, Ratzfaz, would you mind digging a little bit more over here, maybe? And because Ratzfaz is the best digger and we want to keep the other two building, I'm going to take the other guys off digging for the moment. Just Ratzfaz. There we go. Aha, right. Now we've got a storage container. We want to store everything in there except contaminated dirt from the toilet. Ratzfaz, when you get a chance, it would be good to start digging out some of this sand. Sand is subject to gravity, so if it falls, I haven't worked out exactly what yet, but some things, when it falls on it, destroys. Of course, that's not ideal. Right, granite blocks. There. Next floor down would be here and here. And we want to dig along there. Woohoo! Research is complete. Perfect. Right, we'll just power through all the basic stuff now. In any order, we'll just go top to bottom. Now we need to break through to the water. And oxygen. We shall get an algae terrarium. And we'll get it about here. Maybe a little bit further along. It helps to scrub the carbon dioxide out of the air, as well as adding oxygen. But these things, they use water by the gallon, so we don't want to rely on them for very long. We don't want too many of them either, but we do want a few. Just in strategic places, such as down here would be a good place for an algae terrarium. Good, so Babom now can reach the water down there. Which means that the algae terrarium up here can be supplied with the water needed. Alright guys, you're doing really well. Let's have another algae terrarium down here as well. Yeah, you can see all of the red gases, that's the carbon dioxide building up. Now sweeping, the thing that we could do with sweeping first is just that lot. So anyone who's not doing anything else, if you can get that swept, it'd be great. But Ratzfaz, it'd probably be better if you did some digging actually. And we can put some more furniture in. I did mean to get the tiles up here built before they deconstructed, but they'll be able to climb up there and build it from the top. Okay, how are we going? Not too bad, just doing that bit of tidying up there. The reason I wanted to pick up this is because as the water level drops, we'll need to dig away this level and we'll start losing some of this material into the water. And there was algae and stuff in there that's quite useful to have our hands on. There we go, so they've got all of that now. Right, now we're down to 14,000 calories, so the next thing we're going to need is some food. So let's get some food preparation in place. And that's going to need electricity. Oh, and research complete. Well done, Calum. Calum is storming through this. Yeah, it's definitely a good idea to start your team with a very good researcher. Now we can take a little bit more of this away. Yeah, they're starting to struggle for oxygen a bit up there. This'll help, it's starting to produce oxygen now. Right, now food. At the moment we can only make one thing, which is mush bars. Mush bars being made out of dirt and bottled water. And 1,000 calories takes 75 kilos of water, which is a huge amount, and 75 kilos of dirt. So they're basically eating processed mud. And as well as it taking a lot of dirt, which is a limited resource, and water, which is a limited resource, so it also causes diarrhea. But for the moment, it's all we've got. Okay, so they've got things to be getting on with there. If you can, guys. More floor would be good. Now, Ratzfaz, I don't really want you cooking. I'd rather keep you to the construction work because you're so good at it. Well, Ian has the only cooking skill in the house, so I think we'll let Ian do that. Don't worry, Rats, the oxygen will soon get up there. We want to start making more oxygen. Could probably do with doing is getting another terrarium up this side. Maybe over here. Because this is where the carbon dioxide is pooling at the moment. It would probably help if we dug out some of this. See, we're going to have a wall there. That'll be floor. Oh, that was where muck root comes from. I did wonder. Bed beyond reach. Who's... Oh, that's just Ratzfaz. Right, Rats, I'm going to let you build as well now. be a good idea to dig out that block there so that you can get yourself back again. Hang on, he's suffocating because of where he's got himself. Make that a priority. There you go. Okay. Well, three people have got a bed. Oh, poor Ian. Slow to bed. Gets to sleep on the floor. Oh, but he did fall asleep next to the oxygen generator, so he should have a nice sleep, whereas the other guys are going to have to get up in the middle of the night when they can't hold the breath anymore. Don't worry, that won't be too long. Right, let's speed things up a bit more. Research complete, that's liquid piping done. So, Calum, next thing, power regulation. Why did you choose to sit up there next to the toilet to have something to eat? I suppose the oxygen is sort of flowing up here for the moment. Falling asleep at the top of the ladder. Oh, the toilet's out of action. That might cause us problems. We had better... Calum, what's wrong? Try moving over here. Uh-oh. And who's suffocating? Okay, they're fine, but they're desperate to go to the toilet and the toilet's still blocked. Oh, someone's gonna make a mess on the floor. We are gonna have to get ready with the mops. Oh, here we go. Right. Who's made a mess? Calum. Oh dear. Okay. That's not going to pollute our water supply because we made sure to dig this deep enough. But it is going to upset them. They don't like... Oh, and there's Ratzfaz as well. New duplicant! Welcome to our colony. Sorry, it's a bit stinky. Right, who have we got? We have... bottomless stomach we could do without for the moment, and flatulence we could do without toxic gases in the air. But can't dig it. Someone who can't dig isn't too much of a problem for us. And... they're very good at athletics. So, decor expectation is a bit high, and stress response destructive means that if they get really stressed, they'll start destroying things. But, well, I think it's gonna be a long way here. Who is, well, another person who's always quick to the stream these days? Lokii. Yeah. Good at athletics and a pretty good engineer as well. Sounds good. Come on, Lokii, you're in. Please feel free to come and join the mopping up pee party. Don't want you cooking, and don't want you generating power. No, actually, you can be another one who generates power. You're our best composter. Don't want you researching. Don't want you harvesting. In fact, we'll just leave the harvesting to Ratzfaz. Not that we've got anything to harvest at the moment. Yeah, otherwise, I think we're good. Oh, no art. We'll wait for Potato to join us before we let anyone do any artworks. Okay, did we get all of the messes up? Not quite, but nearly. They'll all be really upset about that. And we could do with having the sweep down here as well. Not sweep. Cancel that. Don't want you to spend your time sweeping. I actually meant mopping. Okay, now. Ooh, that toilet's getting a bit stinky. Oh well. But this will help. Not with the stinky toilet, but with the lack of oxygen around here. Because it'll start soaking up this carbon dioxide that's unbreathable. Oh, who didn't get a bed this time? Oh, Lokii was quick to bed. So poor Ian's on the floor again. Just goes to show, fastest on your feet gets the bed. Calum? It's bedtime. Wow, Calum's worked through the night. There is sometimes a bug where whoever's on the generator doesn't go to sleep, but I've not seen that on the stations before. Right, but we are going to have to start getting some more efficient oxygen generation in here. Oh, well done. Interior decoration. And while you do that, we'll get somebody else to build you a supercomputer. And somebody else can build an algae deoxidizer. We'll put that there in the center. And that should be enough to keep them going for a while. And what I'm going to do over here is build another outhouse. We could probably do with another storage container over here as well. Food's looking a little bit low. We probably need to start putting a priority on that. Keep Ian busy. And how about we build Ian a bed? Yeah, the algae are good at being early game carbon dioxide scrubbers, but they don't emit much oxygen. And I say they use such an awful lot of water. I'm glad the toilet's back into use. Okay, anything except contaminated dirt. We go, and now everybody's got a bed. And we've got the algae deoxidizer will pump out far more oxygen. It's making that 400 to 600 grams per second, whereas these things make around about 30 to 40 grams per second. This is a huge improvement. Now it only works if the air pressure's not too low. This isn't too high. Because it doesn't take anything out of the air, it just adds additional gas. Ooh. Right, so we've done all of the basic research. It's time to start... Right, time to think about this. There's some things that we want really quickly. We want pressure management for the airlock. We want... percolation for the electrolyzer. We need combustion to be able to deal with the hydrogen gas that the electrolyzer makes, and we need the gas filter to be able to handle the gas that the electrolyzer makes. So I think we'll start with pressure management, because that will help to keep the bad smells from the toilet at bay. Keep all the we'll lock the toilets behind closed doors so that the toxic gases then don't sneak into the base, and it's not something we need to deal with straight away. Oh, look, we've got meal wood up here. So meal, the suspiciously mobile meal wood fruit is ready for harvesting up there. Now if we leave it a little bit longer, it will still be harvestable and we'll get seeds off it as well. We're definitely going in that direction anyway. Now Ratzfaz, while we're over here, it would be quite handy if you were to dig down a little bit. Because if you do that, it'll give the carbon dioxide somewhere to go. Of course, you could just fall asleep. And we can start thinking about getting another cot in for our next duplicant that arrives. Okay, we are making some serious progress here. Something that we're going to want digging pretty fast is that algae, because the downside of the algae deoxidizer, and why I've put off using it until as late as I could, is because of how fast it burns through the algae. 800 grams a second, that's almost a kilogram of algae a second. Let's see how much we've got. So we have 2,000 kilograms. So that's 2,000 seconds that we can survive with the algae that we've got. And we'll just have a think about this. We've got 20,000 calories stored up. How many calories are we actually using? Because we don't have a fridge and stuff goes off. We're eating about 4,000 a day, so we've got 5 days worth of food. So I'm going to stop them from making any more for the moment. Let's see what we've got. Now, anything else before I let them get going again? No, except we are coming up to somewhere around about an hour. Maybe we'll just let them do a bit of sweeping. I'll show you a couple of things. If we have a look at the decoration overlay, you can see whoever's sleeping up here has quite a nice, isn't quite a nice environment, whereas the closer you get to this end, the worse it gets. And we can improve that a little bit just by removing the clutter. So the clutter here is minus 93. And so the total decoration value at that particular bed is minus 75, and that's just because of all the rocks on the floor. So how about we get them doing a little bit of sweeping, because this isn't going to get any dirtier from this point. Or maybe we should have swept down this end where people are actually sleeping at the moment. Yeah, we'll do that. We'll cancel the sweeping up this bit. We'll do that later. If they run out of things to do, they will spend their time sweeping. Okay, and as they all go to sleep at the end of Cycle 8, I think it's about time we call this episode to a close. So thank you for watching, and do join us again. Next episode will be out quite quickly for a bit more... Can't remember the name. Oxygen don't starve. Oxygen not included. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.